I wanted to revisit the chart that we created at the end of the last live coding session. Hopefully, one thing that you noticed that was conspicuously absent was any sort of context around the chart. The most extreme example of this might be a chart without any labels or axes or even a title. But this may seem silly. Most charts would at least have axes and tick marks, but even with axes and tick marks and values at those axes and tick marks, unless we label what the y and what the x coordinates represent, it's very hard for a reader to interpret what's actually being displayed. You always want to make sure that any chart you create has both clearly displayed units, in this case, millions for the attendance and years for the x-axis, as well as informative labels that shouldn't require any additional explanation. If I label the x-axis year, it should be readily understandable to a reader, and the same applies to the y-axis of attendance. But even with these additions of label tick marks with clear units and labels on the y and x-axis, a reader is still left in the dark about what's actually being displayed. For this chart, before we add the title, even though we have an idea that it's some attendance plotted against years between 1930 and 2014, if we don't know what the attendance actually represents, the chart's quite meaningless. As you can see, even the simplest additions can have profound effects on how interpretable your chart is and how effectively you convey your overall message. And while dimple.js might be great for many common chart types and allows us the flexibility to adapt them by exposing the underlying D3 objects, we will begin to start customizing and adding to our chart enough so that it makes sense to work at the level of D3 itself. Part of this is due to the fact that D3 is much more flexible and allows for complex interaction and animation in your graphics. And the third point, while it may not be relevant to someone who's creating graphics in production or has already learned D3, this being a course to learn about visualization, by working with D3, it really helps you to understand what higher level libraries are doing, such as dimple.js, how to debug their issues when they do arise, and to feel more confident about what's going on with the library itself and how to adapt it.